Hello friends, in our environment chapter number 15, after taking all information and after learning textual exercise question and answer, now we going through the textual exercise. The first is, which of the following groups contain only biodegradable items? The groups can be given are grass, flowers, leather, B, grass, wood and plastic, C, fruit peels, cake and lime juice, D, cake, wood and grass. Here some print mistakes, slight print mistake can be occur in the question which are in the textbook. Here the word is non-biodegradable can be occur. Here non can be not given because grass, flowers and leather are the biodegradable. Fruit peels, cake and lime juice biodegradable, and cake, wood and grass biodegradable. One item is non-biodegradable, which is we know, we aware about the plastic. One is non-biodegradable. So when question arise with non-biodegradable, the answer is B. But now going through the textbook questions, here the answer is A, C and D. Let's see next. Which of the following constitute a food chain? When food chain make a food chain in any ecosystem, first producer can arise, then herbivores and then carnivores or omnivores. So first grass dependent on wheat and dependent on mango cannot possible. Grass cannot take food from the wheat and wheat cannot take nutrition from the mango. Grass are producers. Goat can be depend on grass and human can be depend on goat. Human like as omnivores, we can see in the types of consumers, human considered as omnivores. This make a food chain. Goat cannot depended on or get goat. With the help of goat, cow cannot make nutrition, and with the help of cow, elephant cannot make nutrition. It's not a food chain. Grass, fish cannot depended on grass and goat cannot depended on fish. To decide food chain, you have to go in inward order. Suppose mango cannot depended on wheat, wheat cannot depended on grass for nourishment. Human depended on goat and goat depended on grass. You have to go through inverted order and decide food chain. The answer is B. Let's see third. Which of the following are environment friendly practices? Environment friendly practices. First is carrying cloth bags to put purchases in while shopping. to reduce the use of plastic, you can use cloth bags to put purchases. Switching off unnecessary lights and fans. Switching off unnecessary lights and fans whenever not needed to save the electrical energy. Third, walking to school instead of getting your mother to drop you on her scooter if the distance is short, not in long distance. If the distance is short, you can walking it or you can cycling and go to your school. The fourth is all the above. So this all are the environment friendly points. So the answer is D. Let's go through question number 4. The question number 4 is, what will happen if we kill all the organisms in one tropic level? The answer is if we kill all the organisms in one tropic level, food, which is homing, chemical energy. Cannot be transferred to or cannot be passed through any or cannot be passed through next tropic level. The second is the entire food chain will be or will disturb. Another thing, in second way, or here one more thing is arise, all organisms are depend on it are died. The second way, in lower tropic level, number of organisms are increases. Let's see. We already study one example of food chain in in-text questions. था. We make the food chain in the question, which is suppose grass, mouse depended on grass to obtain their food, snake depended on mouse to obtain their food, and hawk depended on snake. So we see the answer of fourth, not fifth. So when we write, if we kill all the organisms in one trophic level, the energy cannot pass through next trophic level. When we kill one trophic level, organisms of one trophic level, the whole food chain is disturbed because snake are depended on mouse to obtain their food. So snake cannot get their food, the energy cannot pass. And when mouse cannot eat the grass, so in lower trophic level number of organisms are increases. So in this example, the numbers of grass are increases and whole food chain is disturbed. The question number fifth, will the impact of removing all the organisms in a trophic level be different for different trophic levels? Can the organisms of any trophic level be removed without causing any damage to the ecosystem? Let's write the answer first. The impact of removing all the organisms in a trophic level be different for different trophic levels. Let's see one example. If we remove producers any living organisms does not obtain their food. The second is, suppose if we remove organisms of higher trophic levels or higher trophic level, make a comma, increase in number of lower anthropic level organisms. As per our answer 4, if we remove organisms of higher tropic level, increase in the number of lower tropic level. If we remove producers, any living organism does not obtain their food and whole food chain can be disturbed. So, second question is, can the organism of any tropic level be removed without causing any damage to ecosystem? So, without cause of damage any removal of any tropic level cannot be possible. When we remove any organisms in any tropic level, the food chain can be disturbed and the damage can be occur in the ecosystem is must. So, we cannot make harmful to any ecosystem.